Welcome back into Yellowhammer Radio with Cliff Sims. As always, we try to get the top leaders in the state to come on the program and tell you what's going on out there. And today is no exception. We have got State Representative Will Ainsworth on the line. He is the co-chairman of Marco Rubio's Alabama campaign. Representative Ainsworth, how you doing today?
Oh, doing fine. Glad to be in Birmingham. How are you doing?
Good. Well, tell us about that. It sounds like today's an important day for the campaign. What are you guys up to here in Birmingham?
Yeah, in Birmingham, actually, just got finished qualifying Senator Rubio for president in Alabama, and excited to help him lay out a strategy to win Alabama, and think he's going to do that.
What goes into that? You guys have to get a certain number of signatures, is that right?
Yeah, we have to get 500 signatures, and he actually got three times that amount, got more than any other candidate in the state, got right at, I think it's 1,457 signatures. And then also, getting delegates signed up. And right now, he's leading the count of delegates that are signed up in the state of Alabama. So things are looking great right now.
Well, he's definitely kind of in the middle of a big upswing. I saw some polling out of New Hampshire today, which is the first poll that I've seen since his dynamite debate performance last week. And it looks like that he is already experiencing a bump in the polls nationally, probably a bump in interest here in the state of Alabama as well. Tell us a little bit about what compelled you to get involved personally with the Rubio campaign.
Yeah, absolutely. I met Senator Rubio last February. And first and most important to me when I want to support a candidate is, integrity in their faith. And, he's got that hands down. He's a family man. He spends time with his kids. He's involved in coaching their sports. He's been married just once, which is important. He values the sanctity of marriage, but he shares my values. So that was the first box, obviously, that I wanted to make sure we aligned on. And, he's that 100%. Integrity is so important, and faith is important in politics. And so I'm glad that he shares the same beliefs and values as me. Second is that he's a rock-solid conservative. I mean, if you look at the Heritage Foundation, he's got a rating of 93 is the latest updated rating. If you look at other people, just to give you an idea of where he stands, Jeff Sessions, our great senator, scored 89. So, I mean, he is a strong conservative, actually ranked right now fifth in the entire U.S. Senate for conservative rating. So he shares my conservative values as well as a lot of people in Alabama. The third thing, I really was looking for a candidate that can unite our party. And, I think right now, whether you're an evangelical, whether you're Tea Party, whether you're part of the Chamber of Commerce, you're a young Republican, an old Republican, I think he is the guy that can unite our whole party and that can give us the excitement and a candidate we haven't had in a long time, which kind of leads me into my next point. I want somebody that can win. I want to win the White House back. I want to get great Supreme Court justices back in place that are going to undo some of this mess that's happened the last 8 years. And, I think it's time we get a great candidate that everybody that's a Republican can be excited about. I just think back to some of the candidates we had, Bob Dole, John McCain, even Mitt Romney, and we wonder why we lost. And so when we finally got somebody that can not only, is he a conservative? Yes. Is he a Christian? Yes. Is he can he unite the party? Absolutely. But he can win, and he can beat Hillary Clinton, which is so important, and get the White House back for Republicans. And I think he's great on policy. I mean, if you listen to, just his content and his understanding of, policy, whether it's, domestic or foreign, hands down, he has the best understanding of the issues and solutions to those problems.
A lot of our listeners will be familiar with your good buddy, State Representative Ed Henry. I don't know if I haven't run this nickname by you, but you and Ed to me are like the Bash Brothers down in Montgomery. Like any tax that comes up, y'all are bashing it. Y'all are like setting everything on fire. Really, your approach to some of the things in the legislature is probably, if I had to pick a federal elected official to compare it to, in some ways, it would be like a Ted Cruz. And so I think a lot of folks, whether you were Ed, may have expected you to be like in a Ted Cruz type camp. What was it that makes you choose a Marco Rubio over a Ted Cruz?
Yeah, and I respect Ted Cruz, and think he's a great member of the Senate. To me, I just think Senator Rubio just really, his electability, his ability to win, his ability to articulate. I mean, you've seen in the debates how great he is. I think that's one of the things we've got to have. Not only do we have to have the right message, but we have to have the right messenger to get that message out and to get people excited and to get people proud to be a Republican. And, you know, that's really what inspired me. When you look at his story, it's amazing. It's what the American dream is made of. Marco Rubio's parents were, his dad was a bartender, his mom was a maid, and now he's got a great shot at being, you know, the Republican nominee. And I think if he is the Republican nominee, he'll end up being president. And that's the American dream.
It's a remarkable story.
Yeah, and so that's what inspires me to want to support him and work hard to get him elected, because he is a great candidate. He's a great person. He's a great husband and father, and he'd be a remarkable president.
Yeah, I was fortunate enough to get to spend a pretty good bit of time with him when he was in the state earlier this year, and I was really blown away by his depth and breadth of knowledge. I mean, we were in a meeting with we had some defense folks there. We had some, you know, the folks in the financial services industry there. We had, I mean, it was kind of a diverse group of folks, healthcare industry folks there. And going from around the table as he was discussing those issues, the defense contractors wanted to ask him about, you know, military, foreign affairs, et cetera, et cetera. He just goes down the list. I mean, just unbelievable, point by point by point. We move straight over to the CEO of one of the country's biggest banks, ask him a question, just way down in the weeds policy on economics, and he's able to talk about that. Same with healthcare policy. I was just really impressed by him as a person, as a communicator, and just with his depth and breadth, his knowledge, as I said. But also, there is, I guess, the one concern that you hear come up when you talk to people about Marco Rubio is that one prickly issue of immigration. And here in Alabama, it's been an important issue for us for a long time. We had, at one point, the toughest in the nation immigration law. Senator Jeff Sessions, who's been a leader on that issue, is obviously from here in Alabama. What, in your discussions with Senator Rubio, what is your take on where he's at on immigration? Because I just think that's such an important issue to folks here in the state.
Yeah, great question. I think he's got a great plan. You know, I think, number one, obviously the border. He's for building a fence. He's for securing the border. And not only just building a fence, but making sure we have the personnel there so if people start digging tunnels that, you know, hey, we need a secure border. And he recognizes that and is willing to, I mean, that's part of, you know, his plan. Number two, if you look at illegal immigrants in the U.S., 40% are here because they overstayed their visa. And, you know, we've got to crack down on that. And government's got to do their job of managing. And so, I mean, his plan is to restructure that program to where when people come in, we make sure that, hey, if your visa runs out, you know, it's time for you to go back or apply for another one. But we've done a poor job as a government of managing that. 40% of illegals here are because of overstayed visas. Number three, you know, Alabama's done E-Verify, done a great job at leading the, you know, the country and some immigration reform, and he thinks that that needs to be part of, you know, in every state we need E-Verify. And obviously, if there's not jobs here, the people aren't going to be here. And so that's important. And four, I think cracking down on sanctuary cities. But he's not for amnesty. And, you know, he's got a very good plan on how to deal with making sure people don't get into the country.
How do you view the race? And we're talking to State Representative Will Ainsworth. He's the co-chairman of Marco Rubio's Alabama campaign. How do you view the race from kind of a 30,000-foot perspective? You know, there's still a lot of candidates in the race. What do you expect to happen between now and March 1st when we have our primary that's going to position Senator Rubio to be in a good place, have a good opportunity to win the state of Alabama?
Yeah, you know, I think the field's going to obviously get smaller. I think kind of everybody, you know, knows that. And I think, you know, you're kind of starting to see, you know, who the finalists are going to be. And I'm sure that'll shape up some more over the next few months. But, you know, I think Senator Rubio is going to be one of the top, you know, two or three considerations in Alabama. When I talk to people, even if he's not their first choice, he's their second. Mm-hmm. But right now, I mean, it's encouraging the amount of people. I mean, we're probably averaging 5 to 7 people a day that are coming on board wanting to volunteer. And so, and they're not just, you know, hey, what can I do? I mean, they want to help and actually get out there and win because they are eager to win the White House back. And they believe Senator Rubio is the one candidate that can do that for the Republican Party.
Yeah. You know, as I look at the field right now, in spite of Donald Trump's high polling numbers, I just can't quite bring myself to think that he's actually going to carry this thing all the way to Election Day. I really do think he's probably going to end up dropping out at some point if he continues to to go down in the polls or people continue to gain on him, he can't deal, I don't think, with being second in anything. I think he would exit the race before he would come in second anywhere. Ben Carson, I think, actually has probably a little bit more staying power than Trump in some ways. He has built out a grassroots nationwide network of small dollar donors. I think I saw he'd got 800,000 people have donated to the Ben Carson campaign. It's pretty impressive. So I think maybe he sticks around. But then after that, you got Jeb Bush, who's just, it's a disaster right now. You got Ted Cruz, who I think has some staying power, and Rubio. I mean, those, it really comes down to that handful of folks. And in Alabama, my view is it may end up coming down to Carson, Cruz, and Rubio, and I think that you got to feel pretty good about your guys' chances if it gets down to that point.
Yeah, we really feel good about our chances against any of them. I think, you know, when people do their homework and realize, you know, everything that I've come to find out about him, they're going to want to support him enthusiastically. And, you're right, talking about some of the other candidates. I was shocked to see that Jeb Bush canceled his, saw that earlier, trip to Alabama. And one thing I want to let all your listeners know is that Senator Rubio is going to be coming to Alabama December 1st to Gunnersville. And we haven't really put that out yet, but figured let you know first. And so we're excited about that. And that'll be open to the public to come hear him speak. And, you know, he does an amazing job.
That's awesome. You know, that's one of the things that frustrated me the most about Bush's campaign to this point is he hasn't spent time hardly at all outside of maybe Iowa and perhaps New Hampshire, I guess, with real voters. I mean, he'll get in the room with some high dollar donors and hobnob. But like when he came to the state of Alabama last time, he did no press, didn't meet a normal Alabama voter at all. And now he's canceling the one event in which he might actually have had an opportunity to meet some just regular average Alabamians out there. And Alabama's not going to support Jeb Bush. I think there's no way, no how. I just got a tweet came in here, Will. It's from one of our listeners named William, and he wanted me to ask you about Senator Rubio's fundraising ability. I think that's one of the concerns that some people have expressed is Senator Rubio only raised about $7,000 in the state of Alabama in the past 3 months. What are you guys doing right now that you think is going to better position him to start getting some of the money in the door? And I know it's a frustrating part of politics, but it's just the reality. If you don't have the message to the money to get your message out there, you can't win. What are you guys doing to address that?
Right. So right now, I mean, he's third in actual cash on hand in the race. And right now his fundraising is on fire. I mean, he is picking up people every day, endorsements, money. I mean, there's a lot of people. And he raised right at, I saw an article this morning, over $1 million, and three quarters of that in one day was from small donations. Hmm. So, you know, I don't think money's going to be a problem with him. I think it's going to be just really, I think he's in a position to win. I think he's going to have the money to be competitive. I think he's got the correct message, and I think he's hands down the best messenger to get it out. So,
well, that's it. Yeah. Well, we sure appreciate you taking the time to come on here and talk to us about this. It's Will Ainsworth. He's the state representative from Gunnersville, and he's now the co-chairman of Marco Rubio's campaign here in Alabama. Will, I'm sure we'll have you back on the program here soon to get another update on the campaign, and we'll look forward to seeing the senator on December 1st when he comes here to the state.
Absolutely. Sounds great.
Thanks, Will.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, let's take a quick break here. Appreciate your questions coming in on Twitter. If you want to weigh in on what you think about State Representative Ainsworth's I guess just how they feel like the Rubio campaign is positioned right now in the state of Alabama. I think it's he's got a real opportunity. I think it's going to be interesting to see how it plays out. If you want to weigh in, 866-551-9933. Cliff Sims, Yellowhammer Radio, back in just a minute.
This is Yellowhammer Radio with Cliff Sims.